James is not the only entrepreneur who is outside Zimbabwe. I have just mentioned Strive Masiwo, Econet, and others. See, there was a period of madness where the government there was just lashing out, looking for scapegoats, accusing people like James of externalizing money, of involvement in foreign currency dealing, when it was well known that the main player in the foreign currency black market was the government itself through the Reserve Bank. A lot of people have been calling for sanity to say, even a judge, a High Court judge, said the businesses were forced to change money on the black market just to remain in business, otherwise they would have folded and more people would have been unemployed. So there is a realization that two things have to happen in Zimbabwe. One, the politics has to be sorted out. And only when you set out the politics and you fully re-engage with the international community can we talk about a meaningful economic upturn. And for that upturn to have substance, it's very, very important that indigenous. Yeah, it's important for entrepreneurial Zimbabweans who are currently out of the country to return to Zimbabwe and be part of that economic upturn and drive that economic upturn. And there's no doubt in my mind that in the very foreseeable future, we'll see James going back.